All right, Steve. Steve, oh, oh, baby, shut up about Brexit. Yeah, shut up about it. Nobody wants to hear from you. Be quiet about Brexit. You're not going to stop it. It's one of the people. Shut up. That's it. All right, Steve. So you don't like it up here, do you? You don't like it when we're doing it, ruining your morning. Yes, you, with a loud hailer, ruining every single one of our news broadcasts. Now we're ruining yours. Put it down. Mine's bigger than yours.
It's not.
Yes,
it's
you.
Not actually.
Mine is bigger than yours.
His is bigger than yours, Pierce. So
I have a bigger megaphone than yours, Steve. Right now, you have been out megaphone.
Oh, he's given up.
Revoke Article 50!
Pitches aren't scary.
Not
well, fortunately,
about.
We have
he's
some
only
pitches
diddy,
in the
isn't
studio.
He's only diddy.
Well, that's his deck, of course.
Oh,
yeah,
here come
oh, God, he's got pitches.
This is Trevor,
well,
our handler.
Honestly, are we have goldfish by next week?
Who's going to hold a pigeon? You're going to have a go?
Piers.
Nobody. Just let them fly around.
No, they can't fly.
We've Piers. gone from 20-foot pythons to street pigeons.
Put your head back a little bit.
Oh,
now,
my
does this, if your son Spencer is watching, of course, he drew a comparison between your good self.
It's so cringe-making that our leadership is so bad, isn't it?
It is. It's time for someone to step up. Someone whose initials are also the same as Prime Minister... Someone that people have clamoured for weeks, months, nay, years, since the referendum result of 2016. I'm not talking about Boris Johnson or Nigel Farage. I'm not talking about Jeremy Hunt or Dominic Raab, even. I'm talking about the PM, the man they all... No, I'm not talking about you. You'd be a hopeless Prime Minister.
Actually, I'd be brilliant. I'd be brilliant. I'd have a very special relationship with the President of the United States.
Oh, yeah, so we'd get a
right?
trade deal.
We would sort the New World Order out, and I would get stuff done. You know, cabinet.
What would you get done?
Here's what I would have done if I was there. Sign of a cabinet rebellion early on, bang, out, all of you, yeah. All of you.
What would have happened to Chris Grayling?
Oh, my God.
My days.
I would have put him in a taxi, but I didn't think he'd crash it, honestly. It would be, honestly.
Yeah?
Honestly, bang, gone. Any disruption, Boris, naughty boy, out, right? We should let them all sit there, festering, plotting, and from that way on, authority gone. Leaders have to lead, right? You have to have total loyalty. Otherwise, out, gone.
Bye.
Yes. You have contestants, obviously, on The Apprentice. You know, how do you handle it there? Yeah. What do you think about this new issue, which everyone has to deal with in television?
You're talking about the... are you talking about the twice BAFTA awards winning Apprentice?
We are
you talking about that programme?
Yeah.
You know what? You're the only
okay.
person where the BAFTA award is better looking than you.
Yeah. Anyway.
Lord Sugar, we'll talk to you in just a moment.
I want one of them. I want one of them. Oh, can I have one
I've
of them,
got one
please?
Of them.
No, you can't. No, you can't. Sorry.
I've got one of them. And may I also point out that BAFTA statue, its forehead moves more than yours does. And there's a reason for that, isn't there?
Well, anyway, listen, it's a shame we didn't get one on Sunday, but
I
feel sorry for your team. Not for you.
Yeah.
I mean, the reason you didn't get one on Sunday was because... when the awards were, it's mainly because of you.
So we lost you to the polo lounge.
I've been in there with DiCaprio. I tried to get him in. He said, "Piers who?"
You've been with DiCaprio?
Yeah, in the polo lounge.
"Piers who?"
"Piers who?" Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I said, "Come on." And he went, "Piers who?"
No.
He's made that up. I've met DiCaprio.
Well, he is just give you the custard pie. So
are you serious?
Yes, absolute custard pie.
"Piers who?" Have you really been
Yeah, he's in there with a baseball cap on. I've just been on his table.
Hashtag
Why didn't you bring him in? You should have brought him in here.
He is who? I left him to come see Roger because I ain't seen Roger for ages.
Congratulations to all the winners and commiserations to all the losers. A commiserations as well to you, Piers, because we had a slightly awkward moment earlier. When
Vinnie Jones just trying to ruin my reputation.
He went into the famous Polo Lounge, which I think has been the set of about 14 different Hollywood movies. He went there just moments ago and said that he was hanging out with Leonardo DiCaprio. And he said, "Leonardo, would you like to come and join Piers Morgan here at the desk?" And Leonardo said, "Piers who?"
I don't believe